thank you all for convening at this late hour. 43 minutes ago, we were alerted to an incident at the Wallace Bromley Medical Center. While the details are still coming in, it appears to be another anomaly whose mysteries and origins remain the sole purpose of this committee. I called you together tonight to introduce you to my new team, who I've tasked to assist us in our investigation of these events. Hopefully, they'll have more success than our last. Walter Bishop, dubbed by his contemporaries as the successor to Albert Einstein, worked for the Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency from the late 70s.
Until he was committed to the St. Clair's Mental Institution for manslaughter.
He was never convicted of that crime.
But in one of your own reports, you theorize that Bishop's previous work may itself be the root of all these unexplained phenomena.
Given that he's been hugging a padded cell for 17 years, I think we can probably exclude him as a suspect. However, his knowledge makes him uniquely qualified to assist our efforts while he remains in the legal custody of his son, Peter.
Yes, Peter Bishop, whose history of questionable business practices verge on fraud. Yet, you propose giving him access to information that, if made public, would cause mass panic.
There's nothing we could tell him that he can't learn from his father or deduce himself with a 190 IQ.
What were you thinking when you recruited Olivia Dunham? An FBI agent who had an illicit affair with her partner, a man who turned out to be a traitor.
I was thinking that a woman who didn't hesitate to follow the evidence and expose the man she loved at the cost of great personal pain and embarrassment must surely be worthy of our trust.